everybody. I just wanted to do a quick video of me actually talking as I'm putting on my makeup, since it's always, like, super fast forward. I'm just going to go through, like, step by step what I do and what my favorite products are right now, I guess, and what I've been using every day. So before we get started, I'm going to prime my face. I've been using the Smashbox, primer water, but I've also really been liking the Urban Decay B6 one as well. Sometimes I'll spray that, like, on my brushes or something if I want to do, like, a deeper shimmer on my eyes or something, but the Smashbox primer water is awesome. I love it. After I let that set, I usually go in with the Photo Finish primer from Smashbox too, just to fill in my pores. I have really large pores right here in this area. Yeah, you can see my kids' toys back here. I don't have one of those cool YouTube, like, rooms yet. Hopefully one day I can have all that cool stuff. But for now, this is what you're gonna get. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with this to fill my pore area. I have Miranda Lambert playing in the background. So it's kind of like a, you know, it's like a, kind of like a, it's not a mousse, but it's more like a, I don't really know how to explain it, actually. I'm sure you guys know what I'm talking about, the ones that I've used it. I just kind of put it in my problem area that I was telling you guys about. I think it's a great, pore filler, too. If you guys have any favorite primers, comment down below and tell me, because I'm always looking for a great primer. Sometimes I feel like my foundations aren't that great, and then I'm like, maybe it's just my primer that I'm using that's not the best. But so far, this one is the one I've been going towards. Okay, and I'm gonna go in and prime my eyelids. I use the Naked Weightless Concealer to prime my eyelids. I know a lot of people don't use a concealer to prime. I do, because I'm not going to waste money on an eyeshadow primer. I think this does the exact same thing, as long as you set it and I think you feel like you give your eyeshadow a fair shot. The Weightless Concealer is literally weightless. Like, I love it so much. I also use the Tarte Shape Tape, and I like it. I just find it really thick. So it's obviously super full coverage, which I know a lot of people like. But if I'm not wanting to be, like, super dramatic, I'm not going to use the Shape Tape. I'm going to use something lighter than that. Okay, so now I'm going to set my eyes so I can do my eyeshadow. And I've been using the Wet n Wild contour palette. It has been, like, the best contour palette I've used. And I've hit pan on both sides. So if you guys want a cheap, affordable contour palette, I'm not even kidding. All the YouTubers I watch have been using this, and it's no joke. It's awesome. I love it. I also set my face with this side, too, after I do my foundation. You guys will see. That's what I use to set my face. I really want to try the Laura Mercier translucent powder. I'll get to that eventually. So I'm going to tape my eyelids. Give me a sharp line for my eyeshadow, just like that. I'm sure there's different things you can use for your eyelids besides tape, but this is what I've seen other people use, so that's what I use. Okay, so So now that I have my tape on, I'm going to have like that crease and sharp line right here as well. I know the lighting's not that great in here. I just ordered a ring light thing, so my lighting should be better soon. And I've been using the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette like every day, but I'm actually going to go in with the Tardius Pro palette. It's like my all-time favorite palette ever. This is the colors in it. Really pretty. So for my transition shade, I'm going to go in with the color Innocent. It's this one right here. So I'm just putting that in my crease area for my transition color. I've been trying to do this video all day. And my kids just weren't having it, and they just went down for bed. So here we are. So I have my transition on that one. And the brush I'm using, the name rubbed off. I got them on Amazon. I got like a whole packet. They're synthetic brushes, of course. They're really, really nice brushes. If I can find the ones I got, I'll link it down below. I also have Morphe brushes, of course. I love the Morphe brushes. They're affordable, too. Okay, so now that I got my transition shade in, I'm going to go in with Fierce. It's this color right here. I'm going to use the same brush as well. I'm just going to go a little bit higher with this color. This Tardius Pro palette, I think, is affordable for all the colors you get, and they're so creamy. I've had this palette for so long, too, and I haven't hit pan on anything yet. I just feel like the shadows go on really well and you don't have to use a lot of product, and that's what I like about it the most. So get that color in. I haven't worn makeup in a few days. You guys ever wear, like, not wear any makeup for a few days and you feel like you start looking like a man? That's me right now. Okay, now I'm going to change my brush to a more dense brush, and I'm going to go in with Drama. It's kind of like a maroonish, like, brown color. It's really pretty, and I'm going to hit that right in the V where this tape is. I love this color. I think it's really pretty. It's also good to smoke out your lower lash line with this one, too. Something that's not black. Okay, so now I have that color on. And I'm going to go back in and blend to get rid of that harsh line that I have going on right there. So I'm going to go back in with that first color I used, the Innocent color. I love that color. I know the lighting's not that great, but it's really, really pretty. And then I'm going to do my eyelid. This is a Morphe. Let's see if it's on here. Yeah, it's, well, the number's not on here, but it's this one. It's just like a flat brush. I'm going to go in with Minx. It's one of their shimmers. And it's really, I'm actually going to spray this with that stuff I was telling you about. The Urban B6 spray. It's like a prime and prep. And I'm just going to put this one all over my eyelid. Kind of just darkens it up a little bit. I like how it just kind of like smokes it out a little bit. I find it to be really pretty. So now I'm going to pull my tape off so you guys can see that. Whew. This one's kind of stuck. Then there we go. So you guys can see that harsh line that you get. It's also really easy to do like a wing eyeliner because you have that line to go off of. I'm not big on wing because I haven't like mastered it yet. I mean, I can do one. I would rather just have like a flat line for my eyeliner. Speaking of eyeliner, I've been loving the NYX black eyeliner. It's so matte and black. It's the Epic Ink Liner and it has, put on my forehead so y'all can see it. It's just a felt tip, but it's like perfect. I love it so much. And I've had this for so long and I use it daily. So it works really well. Just black. See, you could take that wing up right there, but I just leave it like this for now. And this eyeliner is so easy to work with. I just love this eyeliner. So pretty. Okay, so I'm just going to close my eyes and just fan this so in case it creases up top. And yes, I use the Jaclyn Morphe. I use this to just fan with. And yes, my Jaclyn Hill palette is never far away from my reach. I'm obsessed. If you guys haven't seen it yet, I'm sure. Super pretty. Definitely worth it. I know it's coming back in stock soon. You guys should totally get it. It's totally worth it. Me and my friend were like waiting in line to get it, and I got bumped off for putting the wrong zip code in for my credit card, and I was afraid that I wasn't going to get it because I had been waiting in line for so long to get it. I got it the morning it launched, the very first time, but I got it. I'm so happy. So for foundation today, I'm going to be going in with the Wet n Wild Photo Focus. I'm obsessed with this foundation. It seriously works amazing. I love it so much. And I'm in the shade, of course, it rubbed off. No, here's it is up here. Buff Bisque. And it is a cruelty-free line as well. I love the Wet n Wild foundation. I was watching Casey Holmes on YouTube and I saw her using it and I couldn't believe how good it looked, and so I knew then that I had to try it out. And it's a $5 foundation, and I think it looks just as good as my Estee Lauder Double Wear foundation, and that's a $50 foundation. And it has a little spatula too, which is pretty cool to apply it. And I've been leaning more towards a brush to apply my foundation lately. But today I'm going to use a sponge, I think. And so I'm going to go back in with my concealers. I'm going to use the one that I prime my eyes with, Naked Weightless, and I'm going to use the Tarte. I have to mix the two because the Tarte is too light for me right now. And then I just go in and I add this color into it to make it not so bright. So now that we have our concealer, it seems really bright right here, but when I'm looking in my mirror, it's not. I just feel like it's the lighting in my house right now. Hopefully when I get my ring light that I just ordered, it will be a lot better. Okay, so now that we have our concealer on, I'm going to go back in with the Wet n Wild contour palette to set my under eye. Basically, I'm just going to set everywhere that I put my concealer. Oh, and this is an e.l.f. brush. It's a highlighting brush, but I use it for highlighting and to set my under eye. E.l.f., they have a lot of good stuff. I was looking at their stuff at Target the other day, and they have such a good variety of primers and brushes and eyeshadows. It's pretty impressive. I always crease really bad right here, especially under my nose area. Okay, so now that I have all that set, I'm going to go in with this brush that I got from Target. It's the Sonia brush, and I'm going to go ahead and bronze up my face. Sorry. Backwards on my computer. And then after I get done bronzing my face, I'm going to go back and set everywhere that I don't have bronzer. I love this bronzer. I'm telling you, I think I paid $3 for this. I love it so much. And I see so many people on YouTube using this as their contour palette. I just feel like it's the perfect bronze shade. If anybody has any other bronzers that they like, tell me, because I love bronzers. I'm not really big on having shimmer in my bronzer, but I'm down to try anything. So bring it under my jawline as well. Okay, so now that I have my face bronzed, I'm going to go back the same e.l.f. brush and I'm going to set my face where I don't have bronzer. So now my entire face is set. I also like to use the Wet n Wild cream contour. I think it works really good. And I do the same thing that I just did, except I'll start with this first, blend that out, and then I'll still set it with the contour palette. I think it works really good. So after I'm done with that, I take this big e.l.f. brush. It's the e.l.f. 101. I haven't rubbed the number off yet. I just like how big and fluffy it is. And I just blend it out. Just like that. And then I go in with this brush. It's just a face and eye highlighter brush, but I like the bristles on it and I just use it to blend. And then I use this side right here to contour my nose. The contour of my nose a little bit, and then I will just blend that out so it's not too harsh. And I'm gonna fill in my brows. This is the brow brush that I use, and I've been using the NYX Cayman Frame, the tinted pomade. I think it works okay. I'm ready to try the Anastasia one though. And this is the color. Let's see the color I have. It's just brunette. Just plain brunette. And I'm going to use a close-up mirror for this. Casey Holmes Spotlight Palette. So pretty. I'm going to fill in my brows really quick. Brow one is done. Look at the difference. I started waxing my eyebrows way too young. Like way too young. And I've struggled with my eyebrows ever since. Everyone says I need to try the whole threading thing. And I have not tried that yet. I should try it. Okay, so now I'm going to go in with the Maybelline Eye Studio in Blackest Black. I'm going to hit that on my inner waterline. Just put that on my waterline. And to set my brows, I'm going to use the NYX Control Freak brow gel. Love this stuff. It works really good. My eyebrows don't move all day. And for a mascara, I'm going to be using the L'Oreal Voluminous mascara in black. This stuff works amazing. I haven't been wearing fake eyelashes lately. I really want to get eyelash extensions, but I keep hearing different things about it. If you've ever had eyelash extensions, comment below and let me know your experience. My eyelashes are pretty long. I just want them to be, I guess, more full. This mascara is awesome. It's like a $7 mascara. It works really good. Now I'm just going to go in with my bottom lashes. Really, really good mascara for a drugstore. Okay, so for blush, I'm going to go in with the Cheek Parade from Benefit. I'm obsessed. I think I paid $50 for this, but you also get all of those colors. And for the blush, I'm going to be using the California one right here in the middle. I'm going to be using one of my Morphe brushes for my blush. I think it's a really pretty blush. Lighting's not that great. Sort of see it. But it's a really, really pretty blush. And for highlight, I'm going to be going in with the Casey Holmes Smashbox highlighting palette, and I have it in the pearl. It's really, really pretty. I'm going to go back in with the same brush that I used to set my face, and I'm going to go in with the outer shade right here. Bring it up here. It is seriously so pretty. I'm gonna hit the tip of my nose with it and keep it slow. Such a pretty highlight. Love it. Okay. To set my face, I'm going to use the NYX matte finish. It's this stuff. My makeup does not move all day long. Just going to fan it a little bit before I put my lipstick on. The best setting spray ever. And for lipstick, I'm going to go in with Copenhagen. I felt like doing a fall lip just for being excited for fall coming. It's the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream. It's in the shade Copenhagen. So pretty. These dry super matte too, which I really, really like. Sometimes with mattes, they don't. And that is the color Copenhagen. I think it's so pretty. And that is my final look for this video. I think it is really, really pretty. I love it. Let me know what you guys think below, and of course, if you're not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. I would really appreciate that, or give it a thumbs up. And thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you guys soon. Bye!